What's up? It's your boy Carcino here. And if the audio's off, let me fix it for a second. Let me get my earpiece in. And yes, I did hear the news. I was too busy talking to people, hanging out. And yes, I did see the news. And I saw that old Dave Griffin is gone. And Dan Gifford, he got rid of him, the owner. He probably got rid of him because they now even sound too much alike. Nobody knows which one is the owner or the GM. But Dave Griffin is gone. And LeBron James acts as if he didn't know what was going on. And he is shocked by the actions of what happened. So LeBron is shocked. So while LeBron is in shock that Dave Griffin is gone, why would he be shocked? Why would any human being believe this crap? We all know better. He's done this before. Not his first rodeo. LeBron has done this many times. He ran Mike Brown out of town before he came there. He was not going to play with Mike Brown again. So Mike Brown was out. Then he got David Glatt gone. LeBron, I like David Glatt. I didn't want him to leave. Sure you didn't. Strange. Once the Kevin Love deal blew up for Carmelo Anthony, and for they wanted Kevin Love, and they didn't get the deal done for Kevin Love, and Griffin was like, I don't want to give up Kevin Love. He fell on bad terms with you because you really wanted Kevin Love out of there? Yeah, we know. You wanted Kev gone. Then you're like, no, I love Kev. I never would have said nothing for him to go. Yeah, you're the guy who sits in on meetings with the union reps and sits in with the commissioner of the league, Roger Goodell. And we're supposed to believe you had no knowledge of what was going on. None. Not a little bit, bro. Just a little bit. You had no, this caught you by surprise. Oh my God, and what about the state of the Cavaliers? Oh, come on. They gonna put somebody in there who Bron wants to get things done. Griffin is already not handling any of the basketball operations right now. Even though he's ready to be let go at the end of the month, he is not responsible for what's happening with this recent decisions being made about trades. But let's be honest. He had nothing to do with getting the coach fired for them to get Tyronn Lue. Coach Lue was in there. Yeah, you did nothing to lobby for Coach Lue. You did nothing to try to lobby to get Mark Jackson. You did no lobbying at all to try to get Melo onto the team and get rid of Kevin Love. No lobbying for them to go get players. And then all of this was done behind your back, and you went out in April and spoke up for the general manager. So you thought he was coming back. You knew he was out. A general manager who won't get an extension after taking a team to the finals three straight times, winning one championship, that's the GM we should fire. He don't have it no more. It's time for him to go to the pastures. Wow. Y'all believe that? Okay. I just want to know if I'm alone, because I know I don't believe it at all. I'm too smart. My basketball IQ is too sharp to believe stupidity. That a major decision can go on that affect the team, that their star player has no knowledge is going to go down. No. He's supposed to be King James, but yet this little thing about his team, he doesn't have a inkling of any idea about. Who would believe something so stupid like, oh yeah, Cleveland fans. They would believe something like that because they're really stupid. So they'll believe LeBron had nothing to do with getting them fired. Then they'll be like, he deserved to go. You know, Cleveland fans are really stupid. They'll just believe anything that comes across. They're like walking zombies. Utterly ridiculous. Completely ridiculous. But that's neither here nor there. Now they're trying to get Jimmy Butler and all this stuff and being active, and Griffin is not even involved in the conversation at all. He's not even handling the business. What did he do that was so egregious? Kevin Love for Carmelo Anthony? Really? Is that a good deal? I don't even think that's a good deal. So I think he actually saved the owner, the organization. This is a guy that brought in talent. LeBron James ran the talent out of town. They had Dion Waiters. You had Andrew Wiggins. He did a great job as far as bringing in talent. They had Tristan Thompson, even though he was a bum. He actually used to play a little bit. You got Kyrie out there. And then now this. You know what I'm saying? They were building for the future. But you come back to Cleveland and want everything to happen tomorrow. So you bring all these other players over and then ruin his job and stop him from being GM of the year. You know, for bringing all this talent over. Now he's got to try to freestyle and bring all these spare parts onto the team. He did the best he could with the little resources he had. Because they like way over the cap. And that's the owner's fault, not the GM. Because if it's up to the GM, he don't never want to be over. But it is what it is. Take my hat off to him. You know, the man tried to do his job. Anybody looking for a GM, there he is. Now let's see who they get to replace him. They get some nutless monkey that's just going to listen to LeBron James. They might as well just announce LeBron James is player and general manager. Who cares at this point? They already know he's running the team anyway, so what difference does it make? It's your boy Carcino. I'm out. Don't forget to subscribe. And all the other good stuff. I'm out. Oh, yeah. Hit the notification button.